previously in different ages, like in Satyuga, Dwapar Yuga and different ages, there were sages who used to perform certain kind of process to attain the Supreme Lord. And it was certainly not devotional service, because they didn't have so much faith in bhakti. So they used to adopt different post processes, and Krishna or Lord Vishnu is only available through devotional service. And because they were not performing devotional service, so they were not able to attain the lotus feet of the Lord. So it used to take them ages after ages after ages, birth after birth after birth. That's why we heard that sages used to perform so much tapasya for so many years, so many years. This was the reason. Because for them, they used to think bhakti is a very simple thing. They used to take bhakti very lightly. But gradually, after spending thousands of years and births after birth, when they used to come to understanding that bhakti is the only process by which one can get free from the contamination of this material world, then they used to perform devotional service and then they used to get liberated. So to come to that understanding that by the means of bhakti only one can attain the Supreme Lord, it used to take them ages. Because there were different modes which were available in different yugas, but even that used to give result, like Jnana Marga and Karma Marga, but that also used to give result only when it is with bhakti. And there was no bhakti in their process. So that's why they used to struggle. In this age of Kali, bhakti is the only process. Rest, everything cannot work here. If you try to meditate on it, if you try to do some sacrifice and this and that things, it will not work. But bhakti is the only process in this age of Kali. And how can we get bhakti? The question is, how can we get bhakti? In Manchester, where is that shop where we can get bhakti? So bhakti is the property of pure devotees. It is only available to the pure Vaishnavas, like Prahlada Maharaj, so many other. So bhakti can be attained only by association of sadhus, and especially hearing Krishna Katha from them. When we get association of sadhus, we should hear from them submissively. If you see there in Srimad Bhagavatam, is full of question answers. And the questions were not asked in a challenging spirit. They were asked in a humble state of mind. They were in a mood, when there is humility, and with humility when somebody asks questions, then understanding of the knowledge, transcendental knowledge, will be digested. Otherwise, when challenging spirit, Krishna is not available with the help of challenging spirit. Krishna will reveal himself. Because transcendental knowledge is revealed in the heart. So we have to be very humble to understand this transcendental subject matter. Srimad Bhagavatam is the best source of Krishna Katha. When we say we have to hear Krishna Katha from sadhus, that means we have to hear Srimad Bhagavatam from them. And Srimad Bhagavatam is so potent that it even captivated the heart of Shukdev Goswami. Shukdev Goswami, he stayed in his womb of mother for 16 years, and he didn't want to come out. But on the request of Lord Krishna, he came out, but then he started straight walking to the forest without performing any purificatory process. He was not interested with anyone. His father was not ordinary person, Veda Vyas. Imagine somebody's father is Veda Vyas. And instead, Shukdev Goswami is just walking. And Vedavyas was saying, what's going on? Because Vedavyas, he compiled so many literatures, Vedas and so many things, and he distributed to his disciples to elaborate and give it further to their disciples. But when he compiled Srimad Bhagavatam, he couldn't find any qualified person amongst his disciples. So then he prayed to Krishna to send a son who is qualified to glorify Srimad Bhagavatam. And Sukadeva Goswami was that person. But then he left for the forest and Veda Vyas was running behind him. Please wait, please wait, please wait. But Sukadeva Goswami was completely absorbed in Brahman and he was completely transcendental to anything. He was not in this world. He was just walking. Then Veda Vyas did a trick. He said, okay. He went back and he sent two of his disciples. And he sent his disciple asking them to recite two verses from Bhagavatam. One is Aho Bakiyam Stanakalakutam Jighansa Payadapya Sadhavi Lebhe Gatim Dhatrochitam Tatanyam Kamba Dayalu Sharanam Vrajeva. This is the one verse which glorifies the quality of the Lord, how he delivered Putana. Putana, she was a demon. But she came disguised as a mother. And then she tried to feed milk to Krishna. She was not having genuine love for Krishna, but Krishna accepted her. Imagine someone is trying to kill you. If somebody walks into this temple with a gun, will after the matter will settle, will we ever think that we should be, will we allow him to stay in the temple? No. Said, you go, get out first. So similarly, here, Putana came to kill Krishna, but Krishna gave her a position of a mother in the spiritual world. So Sukadeva Goswami, when he heard this, Sukadeva Goswami thought, saying, who is this person? Then another verse was, Baraha Pidam Natavara Vapu Karanayo Karane Karam Vivaradvasaha Kanaka Kapyasham Vaijanti Chamalam Randrar Venur Adhara Pura Sudaya Purayan Gopa Vrindar Vrindaranyam Swapadaramanam Pravishad Gita Kirti. It has a description of the beauty of the Lord. How Krishna is wearing a peacock feather upon his head, how he is wearing a blue karnika flower on his ears, and how he is wearing a yellow garment, and how he is wearing a Vaijanti mala, and how he dances in the forest of Vrindavan, how he plays his beautiful flute. So all this description, when Sukadeva Goswami heard, he said, who is this guy? Who is this person? So he went back to his father. And he said, oh my dear father, who is this person? Which your disciples are glorifying? Who is that person? He said, sit down. 18,000 verses. So then Sukadeva Goswami, he sat and heard the entire Srimad Bhagavatam from Veda Vyas. Srila Sukadeva Goswami was very fond of forest life. He was Aranya Priya. But after hearing Srimad Bhagavatam from his father and then further reciting in the assembly of devotees to Maharaj Parikshit, he became Vishnu Janapriya. He became very, very dear to the devotees of the Lord. Vaishnavas, Srimad Bhagavatam is the life and soul of the Vaishnavas. Life and soul. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, he used to hear Srimad Bhagavatam from Gadadhar Pandit at Narendra Sarovar every day. Every day. In Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami lists hearing Srimad Bhagavatam as one of the five essential process of devotional service. Srila Prabhupada, he carried the weapon of Srimad Bhagavatam to the West. What did he carry? What was with him when he went to the West? First three volumes of Srimad Bhagavatam. And with this weapon of Srimad Bhagavatam, he conquered the whole world. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur said that if all the books in the world were destroyed and if only Srimad Bhagavatam remained, nothing is lost. Nothing is lost. Srimad Bhagavatam is a matured fruit of Vedic tree and therefore can grant all desires. All the desires can be simply fulfilled by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, by giving an oral reception to it, by reading it, by taking shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. So the process of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam is the means for attaining all desires. Maharaj Parikshit, simply by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, he attained supreme perfection of entering the abode of the Lord. That's why we request devotees to take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. There are three ways. One is by hearing from the devotees whose life is Bhagavatam. Second, reading with the help of Srila Prabhupada's purports. And third, speaking it in the assembly of worshippers. But if we can simply do these three things, perfection will be attained very easily. What is the perfection? We will become pure unalloyed devotee like Prahlada and Dhruva and so many others which are mentioned in the Bhagavatam. We will become like them. Why? Because we are associating with them when we are discussing Bhagavatam. A person is known by the association he keeps. So when we are always absorbed in discussing about Prahlada Maharaj, Dhruva Maharaj, Pandavas and all the other personalities, we will become like them. We will become Bhagavatas. So here Prahlada Maharaj is sitting in the assembly of his friends and he is discussing glories of Srimad Bhagavatam, glories of devotional service, and he is saying to his friends that the real problem of the life is the repetition of birth and death. That is the real problem. And how can one get out of this repeat problems of birth and death? By constantly engaging in devotional service. Srila Prabhupada makes a point in the purport. He says that constantly engaging in the service of the Lord and thinking about the lotus feet of the Lord. Now thinking means what? Thinking means smaran. Remembering of smaran. Smaran is the third stage. First stage is what? Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam. So while doing certain activities of devotional service, we should be in proper knowledge of what we are doing. Even if we are doing kirtan, we should be in proper knowledge of doing kirtan. That we are doing this kirtan for the pleasure of our spiritual master, and we are doing this pleasure for the kirtan for the pleasure of the Lord. When we are doing any devotional service like wiping the temple, we should know that Amrish Maharaj, the emperor of the whole world, used to also wipe these temples like this. So we should be in proper knowledge. So how will this proper knowledge come? From hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. If you are doing deity worship also, but if we have proper understanding, then the deity worship will become a devotional service. Immediately, we'll be promoted on the platform of pure devotional service. If we have proper understanding of what we are doing, this is the seva which we are performing. That's why hearing Srimad Bhagavatam is very, very important. Prahlada Maharaj is saying to his friends that Krishna is residing as a super soul in everybody's heart. Don't think that he is not residing in the heart of Hiranyakashipu, our father. No. He is residing in everybody's heart. But he is little tricky, you know. Krishna is so tricky. Sometimes our acharyas are right. That Krishna is residing in everybody's heart, then why are there so many wrongdoers in the world? Why don't Krishna stop them from within only to not do a certain thing? Then our acharya is right that Krishna, when he is there in the heart as Paramatma, he actually doesn't do anything. He just sanctions things which are coming by your karma. As per the prarabdha, one has to get certain things, Krishna will just sanction them. But he will not do anything special to help you become his devotee. No. He doesn't want forced love from anyone. So, he doesn't do anything in one sense. But when he is activated, when one is eager to hear about Krishna, when one wants to become a devotee of the Lord, then the super soul is residing as Paramatma in our heart, then he becomes activated. Then when he sees that, this soul of mine wants to know about me, then he arranges Narad Muni for Dhruva Maharaj. Then he arranges Narad Muni for Prahlada Maharaj. So he will send sadhus, he'll make arrangement for sadhus, make arrangement for devotees to come in your life. And he'll give you an opportunity to take to Krishna consciousness. Srila Prabhupada writes that becoming Krishna conscious is very easy. Simple. Simply hearing about the Lord, his glories, his pastimes. But going to hell is such a difficult endeavor, such a difficult task. if somebody wants to go to somebody is trying to have illicit activity, or if then he has to have so much money for the prostitutes because it's not free service. Then if somebody wants to eat meat, then he has to have so much, he has to open so many slaughter houses. And then intoxication, he has to go to so many big pubs and so many places, bars, and he has to spend so much money on it. So in this way, it's so difficult. We need a lot of endeavor is needed for that. But to become Krishna consciousness is very easy. Anywhere in, wherever you are in the world, you can chant the holy name of the Lord. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Wherever you are, you can hear Srimad Bhagavatam. This is wherever you are, we can read Srimad Bhagavatam. There is no special effort required. It's free. Then, Prahlada Maharaj is saying that once riches, when people have so many riches, they have beautiful wife, they have so many female friends, they have their sons, they have daughter, they have their properties, this and that. Prahlada Maharaj is saying that these are all temporary and flickering. These are only there with us for, our life is temporary. And in that temporary life also there are so many ups and downs. And then we have this so much riches, beautiful wife and this and that. And amongst that also the wife is there, she's very beautiful. But still she kicks the husband many a times. But still the person, he doesn't always remember this temporary nature and he wants to enjoy all these riches, all these beauties, all the sons, fame, name, fame, and he wants to gratify his senses. But Prahlada Maharaj is saying that this is temporary and flickering, we should always remember that. And then we should only endeavor for becoming Krishna conscious. Srila Prabhupada writes in the purport that he is saying that you see in the histories of the world, there are so many empires, Roman Empire, Mughal Empire, British Empire, and they for centuries have worked so hard to put such a big empire, but what happened at the end of the day? They are destroyed. They did so much arrangement so that they can survive, but they cannot. In conclusion, why should one waste our time in so-called economic development, which is neither permanent nor pleasing to the soul? So one should do that activity which will help one to advance in Krishna consciousness. But if you are simply behind these activities of sense gratification, and then all our attempts will be disturbed by the nature, disturbed by Maya, because it is not possible for us to enjoy this material world. We will get that much happiness which we are destined to get, and which we will get that much unhappiness or distress which we are destined to get. So why endeavor for something very special? We might try so much different ways to get happiness, but we are not going to get that. Prahlada Maharaj in the next verse is saying, that will come a little later. He's saying that with this understanding, with this temporary nature, this not only is there in this material world, here in this Bhuloka, but also in the heavenly planets, the upperly planetary system also, everything is temporary. Yes, the facilities available there might be very 7-star or 10-star. We might go in 1-star hotel or 2-star, we might stay in 1-star hotel or 2-star hotel. But there are 7-star hotel and 10-star hotels also. But what difference is going to make? Same, the pleasure one gets in here, in the 1-star or 2-star hotel while sleeping on the bed, you get in 10-star hotel also, you'll get the same pleasure. The dog sleeping on the road, he gets the same pleasure of sleep what one gets in the bed, sleeping on a bed. We sleep on the bed, we get the same pleasure. The pleasure of sleeping is the same. So, Prahlada Maharaj is saying that even the heavenly planets, they are temporary. So one should not even endeavor to go for heavenly planets, or in other words, we should not endeavor for some luxurious life. Because even though we get all kinds of luxuries, still, one is not going to get any kind of pleasure. For a say, you go with your family on a tour, you spend lakhs of rupees of money, and then you find out that your business is in loss. You got a call from your office and says that the boss is upset with you. Or if you have a personal business that is going in loss, your share market has crashed and all those things. You are with your family, you spend a lot of money on it, but will you be able to enjoy that? No. That means we were not destined to have that happiness. But still we were trying to be happy. So it is not going to be. So the amount of happiness and distress which is written in one's destiny, one will get that much only. So, Prahlada Maharaja is saying that nobody can achieve the results which one is planning to. Materialistic people, what they do? They make so many plans. That we will do this, we will do that. They have planning commission, this commission, that commission. In offices, every day they have meetings. Every week they have meetings to plan things. But do things work as per the plan? No. Things doesn't work as per the plan. We make all the efforts to plan things very nicely. There is a special team to plan things. But at the end of the day, in the end of the year, we see that nothing has happened as per the plan. If we see what was the plan initially, and if we see, analyze the whole year, nothing has gone as per the plan. So, many times we see that nationalists, economists, and so many ambitious people, politicians, they make great effort. They make great effort to put things together. As a whole nation, let the economy of our country should be developed. And they plan so many things. But nothing works. Because this is the law of nature. Sukhaya dukkha mokshaya sankalpa iha karmina sadapni protihaya dukkham nihaya sukhavrata. Actually, one is happy as long as one does not endeavor for happiness. Prahlada Maharaja is telling you a secret of happiness. Till the time you are depending on the mercy of the Lord completely, then you are working for the pleasure of the Lord, not thinking of anything else, then you are happy. The moment you begin the activities for happiness, some extra effort, and extra endeavor to become happy, then his condition of distress begins. Till the time we are doing completely depending on the Lord Hari and working and offering all the results to the Lord and doing everything, understanding that this ability, we have to understand this ability, this intelligence which I have got to do certain things is given by Lord. Krishna says, I am the ability in man. So there is no question of thinking that I am doing a certain thing. We should know that the Supreme Lord, he is giving us the ability to do a certain things. So till the time we are endeavoring for that, we have this understanding that by the mercy of the Lord, I have got this intelligence, this energy, this strength to do a certain activity. Then things will be very happy and smooth in the life of that person. But as soon as we try to make something new, then the distress begins. So everyone, Prahlada Maharaja, Srila Prabhupada writes that it is better that one should not plan for things and take one day at a time and depend on the Lord and perform his duties. He should only do the duties and allow the results to Krishna to decide. So this is very simple and easy way to be successful in life, to be always happy. Then Prahlada Maharaja is saying that what is this body? He is trying to explain the condition of our body. He is saying that this body is supported by bones. Now we have to understand our temporary body. We are in this, soul is in this body, and we have to understand, now try to understand this body. What is the structure of our body? This body is supported by bones. Exactly like this building is supported by pillars. And it is tied together with the ropes of nerves and veins. Then it is covered with the skin. And what is there inside? Flesh. And every part of the body reeks. And there is nothing, what is inside in the stomach? What is there inside the body? A pot of stool on urine. This is inside the body. From outside, we look very beautiful or very attractive. But what is inside the body? Simply something like, which is called as pot of stool and urine. And then, in old age, the same body, which is very nice and handsome and very beautiful, the same body in the old age, it is a cause of lamentation and misery. People who are growing old, they will know that they were very young and they are very healthy and everything, but now as they are going old, problems are increasing. Problems are increasing. And it is continuously troubled by the desire that can never be satisfied. We have so much desires all the time. We are planning so many things all the time. But and this desires will go on increasing with this body all the time, and these are desires are not going to get satisfied, and we are not going to get satisfied. Every pore in this body is full of defects, and it can destroy at any moment. We can die at any moment, but still we think that our body is permanent, and everything is permanent. All the opulence and everything is permanent. So the point here Prahlada Maharaja is wanting to make is that he is not asking us to leave our family members. He is not asking us to leave our wife and children. And no, he is not asking us to, because he himself got married. See, he is not asking. He is saying that don't be attached to it. Be attached to Krishna. And think that this is all the property of Krishna. And only a servant I'm doing this, but everything belongs to Krishna. So here his point is that not to give up relationship or wealth or everything, but don't get attached to it, only get attached to Krishna. This body has only three destinations. There are three kinds of destinations for this body. First is, if this body is buried, then it will be eaten by worms. Second, if this body is thrown away, it will be eaten by vultures or dogs, or somebody will eat it. If it is burned, it will be converted to ashes. So these are the only three destinations of this body. So who is that sane person who will not utilize this temporary body for a permanent benefit? We will not utilize this. So one has to be very careful how we are using this temporary body. We are in this body, human form of life, and we also have a wonderful platform for practicing Krishna consciousness. We have association of devotees. We have the holy name. We have the Srimad Bhagavatam. So we have to chant the holy name every day. We have to hear Srimad Bhagavatam every day. We have to be in association of devotees and discuss about the Lord and spend our life. As simple as that. And do our duties for our wife, for our children, for our everything, that should go on. But attachment should be only for Krishna. And how will that come? If we hear more about Krishna from the Srimad Bhagavatam. So that will help you. Food which is cooked in the morning, it gets rotten till the evening. In the West, people will not understand that, because they cook once in a week. But food which is cooked, it loses its nourishment immediately after 2 or 3 hours. And gradually at that, till it comes to the end of the day, it has nothing left in the food. Hmm? This is what Shastra says. Your understanding might be different, but Shastra says this. Hmm? So similarly, this body which we consider eternal is been nourished with the same food. So how can this be eternal? So the food by which we are helping to nourish this body, if that food is going to become stale till in the end of the day, then how will this body which is nourished with that food will be eternal? Hmm? So we do this is what Prahlada Maharaj is trying to help us understand. Hmm? This is our situation. Hmm? So he is saying that a living entity gets a particular type of body according to karma or fruitive activities. The material pleasure derived in the material world from one's particular body is based on sexual pleasure. Hmm? When a person is single, he is very very happy. If he is a Mataji or a Prabhuji, when both are single, they are very happy. Hmm? Are you married? You'll find out. You'll find out.
You're saying you have to be in the family.
Now let me complete my sentence. Hmm? When you get married, I'll ask you the same question. They are already experiencing, so they can relate to what I'm saying. Hmm? So Prahlada Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada is saying that when they are on their own, then there is nothing to, there are no worries. Hmm? They can just work and they can be on their own. But when a man thinks of marrying a girl, hmm, then the process starts. Hmm? Then he starts loving a girl, the girl starts loving a man, and then they say to themselves that we should have a house. Hmm? Then they endeavor for house. Hmm? Then when the house is there, then they must have a good house. Hmm? Luxurious house. Then they want a car. Huh? When you are single, hmm, life is so peaceful. But now, for what? Hmm? For this attachment for a girl or for the girl's attachment for a boy, now everything starts. Hmm? This is, Srila Prabhupada calls this as Hridaya Granthi, attachment, not of the heart, Hridaya Granthi. So now gradually this Hridaya Granthi increases. How it increases? Then children come, we have children, then children, their education and their everything, so we get more attached to them, their needs. A sadhu said that a sadhu was asked, why don't you get married? He said that I cannot control my mind. He said, I cannot control my mind. How will I control the mind of my wife? And then if I cannot control my mind, I cannot control the wife of my wife, how will I control the mind of children? That's why I didn't get married. Understanding that I cannot control my mind. Ask this question to yourself. Can we control our mind? We are trying to control others' mind. Our wife's mind, we are trying. Our wife is trying to control husband's mind. Chalo. Mind, husband and wife still. They are trying to control children's mind. Hmm? So, this goes on and on and on. Hmm? And the Hridaya Granthi, it goes on increasing. Hmm? So when we come in association of sadhus, then they do is Hridaya Granthi Bhedam. Hmm? They cut the knot in the heart. Hmm? They cut the attachment by speaking about Krishna. Hmm? They give you higher taste. Hmm? So when we hear about the Lord, when we chant the holy name, when we hear about the Lord, when we hear about his pastimes, then even though we are in that Hridaya Granthi, even though we are in that situation, we will be like lotus. We will be not in that. We will be in the mud, but will be above the mud. Similarly, even though we will be in grahastha life, but still we will be attached to the Lord if we take shelter of sadhus and Srimad Bhagavatam. An intelligent person, he must inquire from his spiritual master about the goal of life. A spiritual master can answer all such questions because he has seen the truth. He has seen what is the truth. So he can help you understand the truth. So it is very important that we get an association of such an elevated soul who has seen the truth and he can explain you the truth. One who is himself in doubt, how can he clear your doubt? One who is himself tied up by the modes of material nature, how can he free you from the modes of material nature? So that's why one needs to associate with a liberated soul. That's why we discussed last 2 days that we need to develop greed for it. To get such an association, we have to pray to Krishna for that, for such an association. So Prahlada Maharaj is saying that we should discharge our occupational duties but fully depend on the lotus foot of the Lord for the result. Karmanyava adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana, the famous verse in India. The only one verse which once I never had any philosophical discussion with my father, because he had a TV news channel and then he was having completely different engagement with politicians and all. But one day he recited a slogan and this was this: Karmanyava adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. I said, wow. So you have right to perform your prescribed duty, but you are not entitled to the fruits of action. According to one's position, one should perform his duties, but for the results, one should simply depend on Sri Krishna. Our only desire should be to become a devotee, perform duties as duties of Krishna consciousness. So that should be the hankering. If there is someone who can change our destiny, it's Sri Krishna, not anyone else. That if you are destined to get some kind of happiness, some kind of distress or some kind of unhappiness or misery in our life, and if somebody can change that, then it's Sri Krishna. Otherwise, we are bound to suffer such kind of problems. Only by taking shelter of the Lord we can get rid of this. Then Prahlada Maharaj is saying, Devo asuro manushyo va yaksho gandharva eva va bhajan mukunda charanam swasti man syad yatha vayam. Prahlada Maharaj is saying to his friends that if a demigod, if a demon, if a human being, if a yaksha, if a gandharva, or anyone within this universe renders service under the lotus feet of Lord Mukunda, then his life will be auspicious, and he will become like us. Prahlada Maharaj is saying, he will become like me. Prahlada Maharaj is saying to his boy, if you also take shelter of the Lord, then you will become like me. You will also remember Krishna all the time. Without sincere devotional service, everything is just a show. If you are practicing Krishna consciousness, then we should be sincerely and honestly practice, and then we should be practicing for pure devotional service. Prahlada Maharaj is saying, if you are practicing pure devotional service sincerely, then otherwise everything is just a show. It will benefit, but the real benefit is when we hunger for becoming pure and all devotees of the Lord. So in this way, actually there are so many long instructions. Prahlada Maharaj's teachings are huge, but I think I should take a pause here. But the whole the essence of Prahlada Maharaj's teachings to his friends, we have discussed that. Now let us try to take some questions. We'll try. if we have any questions.
You sure you haven't missed anything?
No, I have taken. I said that there are so many things are there, but. Paramatma in the heart wants, I should take a pause.
Let's take some questions from the audience.
Yeah.
Just now you said that somebody wants to
connect. You're asking a question?
Yeah.
Okay.
So just now you said that, look, you should not depend on your, also once you do your work. Yeah, that's what it means, right?
The results.
Yeah.
You should not worry for results. The results, if a devotee is doing certain work, then he just performs his duties without attachment.
It's like not exactly on devotional service. I'm talking about the generic service which do outside the day-to-day activities.
Mm-hmm.
Like I do my job, if I won't get paid at the end of the month, should I need to keep quiet or just leave on Krishna, stating that, you know, he'll give the money?
No, we have to, when you work, then you'll get paid, right?
And if the employee is like that,
then find a new employee, then who can pay you? You use little intelligence.
Could maybe elaborate on what that really means? Because most people, when they hear that, they don't really understand practically how they should execute
them. So we are discussing that we are, when we are doing duties for our, for when it, doing our duties means that duties to our wife, to our children and so many other things, we should do that with detachment. We should not expect anything from them.
Nothing, Guruji. Some people get confused.
With?
That detachment means no love.
No.
So if
you... No. Detachment means not getting attached to them on bodily platform. Okay. But that doesn't mean that we don't love our children. And then you say, stay away. I'm detached now. It doesn't work like that. Okay, Krishna consciousness means how are we dealing with others? That is Krishna consciousness. How are we dealing with others? How are we dealing with other? How are we dealing with our family members? How are we dealing with our friends, our relatives? So Krishna consciousness means we should show our love in dealings. So that remaining attached to Krishna and also to his devotees. When Kunti Maharani was praying to Krishna, that Kunti Maharani said that please give me detach, so that I can detach myself from my Pandavas and others. But is Kunti Maharani's attachment to his sons, is it Maya? No. Pandavas are devotees, elevated devotees. So if Kunti Maharani is attached to a devotees, it is good. So our foremost duty of the in charge of the family is to see that the whole entire family is practicing Krishna consciousness. That is the most important duty. If they are not practicing Krishna consciousness, then that doesn't mean that we don't love them. It is our love only which will change their heart. How we deal with them is going to change. Even if they are not practicing Krishna consciousness, but if we deal with them very nicely, then they will take to Krishna consciousness. But if you start hating them, just they are not becoming devotees, then even you are not practicing Krishna consciousness. Krishna consciousness means how we are dealing with others, how we are dealing with devotees. It is very important. We have to encourage others to take to Krishna consciousness, never discourage others.
So that's a journey for me.
That's
a journey from a conditioning point of view. So those who come initially to Krishna consciousness, they sometimes see that their family members are enemies because they're an obstacle. So how should they
I made this point in manner also while giving a class, that if the parents are not devotees, they shall not be mistreated. Because Krishna says to Sudama that parents are the first spiritual master. There are three types of spiritual masters. Amongst that, the first are the parents. Second are the Brahmanas who give upanayan sanskar or instructions on general dealings. And the third, Krishna is saying that one who is an acharya, who teaches about me, is a third guru. So Krishna is accepting, allowing us to think on that, that Krishna is saying that the parents are the first spiritual masters for a person. And because the body which we are engaging in Krishna's service is given to us by parents. And whatever initially in the beginning when we were small, we were completely ignorant about ourselves. So it was parents who took care of us. It was they who changed our diapers. It was they who took efforts and sent us to school. It was they who took all the pains and brought us to a certain standard where we can sit in the class and we can understand what we are discussing now. It is their efforts by which we could read Srimad Bhagavatam. So, even if they are not devotees, or they might not be inclined to devotees, but their representative, you are practicing Krishna consciousness, so it has to be understood that they are also practicing Krishna consciousness. So, this will come to you. So, it is very important how we deal with our parents. Very important. If they are not devotees, that doesn't mean we neglect them. If we neglect them, then we are not doing our duties. Krishna won't be pleased with that. So, and if we show them love with our capacity, if we show them love and affection and care, then seeing us, their heart will change. That's why devotees, when they deal with others, they have to be with the understanding that this person is also human being, and he, Krishna resides in his heart, and by the mercy of the Lord, even he can take to Krishna consciousness anytime. So just now that he is not a devotee, not practicing, and he is somehow associated to us and he is not listening to us, that doesn't mean that we are not good to him. So we have to be good to them always. So that's why Krishna consciousness means is how we deal with others. It's very, very important. Prahlada Maharaj had a demon father. Prahlada Maharaj was a devotee of the Lord, and Hiranyakashipu was enemy of Lord Vishnu. So whenever Hiranyakashipu used to pick Prahlada up and say, "What have you learned in Gurukul?" He used to say, "Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atmanivedanam." Boom! Hiranyakashipu used to throw him. But that doesn't mean Prahlada hated his father. If you carefully read the life and teachings of Prahlada Maharaj, every time Prahlada went to his father, he offered his obeisances to his father. First thing he did was obeisances to his father. He knew that his father might kick him away, but the first thing he did was he was to offer his obeisances to his father. Even though he was a demon, he was an enemy of the Lord. He was always criticizing, chastising the Supreme Lord. But still, Prahlada Maharaj was offering obeisances to him every time he used to go and meet him. This is what we have to learn. How to deal with people.
He asked the Lord to deliver him.
Yes, and he asked the Lord to deliver him. Yes, Prabhuji.
Basically, kind of asking the answer to my question, just a little bit, just broaden that situation. I mean, I cannot quote exactly Prabhupada or the Srimad Bhagavatam or Sadhu Guru Sanavacharis, but the main thing is, it is said we have to kind of avoid communicating, living with people, academies, blah blah blah, etc., etc., etc. Right. So, how to understand this meaning? I mean, but we cannot. I mean, okay, mom and dad is like the same, like the guru. But what about brother? What about my 20-year friends? Yeah. Which already know 30-year old friend. What about them? I mean, do we have to spend
the
least time as possible?
Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur says that if somebody is a Vaishnava, I'll come to your point, if somebody is a Vaishnava, so we should offer all our respects to him, we can even serve him, but if he is not a proper association, then we should not associate with him. He's saying for this for a Vaishnava. But we should serve him. We should offer him all respects. But if he's not a proper association, don't associate. Similarly, if if somebody, anyone of your friends or relatives, it is not that we don't, we should not be friends with them, because it is their fortune that becoming your, they are your friends because you are a devotee. So, so it is their fortune, and devotees are compassionate. They don't, they're not, but we should not associate with them. We should not associate means, if you want to associate, it should be very limited. And not that we take their mood or go to the parties and this and all that thing we should not do. Okay? We should not associate with them. But keeping friendship is not bad. But taking their mood, that is dangerous. If you want to, then they should take your association.
Like Prahlada Maharaj was not taking the demon's association.
Yes.
He was giving association.
Yes. Yes.
Although he was in the
yes.
midst of the demons.
Yes. If that friend of yours, if he has faith in you, if he is your friend for so long, then you should say that, okay, if you are my friend, if you love me, then you should hear what I am saying. Then you can repeat this teachings of Prahlada Maharaj to your friend. If he has faith in, because these demons had faith in Prahlada Maharaj. So Prahlada Maharaj was saying and they were accepting it, even though they were demons. So if someone is a real friend and if he's keeping faith in you, then discuss them about Krishna. Try to may help them in coming closer to Krishna.
Also, there is one person how to associate with different levels of devotees.
Like, yes.
Worship the Supreme Lord.
Yes.
Friends with the equals.
Yeah.
And avoid the envious.
Yeah.
And helps ignorant.
Yes. When one who is younger to us, then we should give all love and affection. One who is equal, we should be friends with them. And when the Vaishnavas were above, we should always respect them. We should offer all our blessings to them and everything. And if somebody, as Vishwanath Thakur gave an example, if he is not like-minded, then one should, with respect, keeping respectful distance. Not that we criticize him outside. No. We should serve them. We should take care, be respectful, and then not associate with them. That we can choose. Hare Krishna.
How come Prahlada didn't remember anything about Krishna, about Prahlada?
We discussed that yesterday. Okay, we would like to answer that. Thank you for your nice question. When Prahlada was in the womb of his mother, that time Narad Muni spoke these instructions to her, to Prahlada's mother. And because her mother, although she was listening to Narad Muni, but she had two fears. She was in a fearful situation because her husband was not with her. And second, that she wanted to protect Prahlada who was in the womb. So her focus was only on these two things. And that's why when Narad Muni was speaking this instruction, she was not able to concentrate and hear. But Prahlada was not like that. Prahlada was hearing Narad Muni's instructions very nicely. And by the mercy of Narad Muni, Prahlada Maharaj could remember always. He couldn't, even when he came out from the womb of his mother, he was able to remember the Supreme Lord always. And the instructions were there with him intact. So this was by the mercy of Narad Ji. Any other questions? Please go ahead.
So, you mentioned that the success or not success, it's basically dependent upon your destiny. Whatever your destiny is destined to happen in your life, it happens. But the point is, we are creating our destiny.
We?
Yeah.
We are creating
our destiny by doing certain things and getting certain results. Like if you do nothing, so destiny and the bad karma will even probably eat your life. If you're not doing your duties,
How to understand it?
What happiness and distress one is going to get by the law of nature or by our own prarabdha, one is going to get that. If only thing it can be avoided is by Krishna consciousness. There is no other way. You cannot do by any way other than Krishna consciousness, you cannot stop the things which are going to happen to you. If you are destined to be very rich, money is going to come to you, it will come. But if somebody is very poor, if somebody is not having money, but is depending on Krishna. But even so, Krishna will see that even though it is not destined in his life that he should have money, so Krishna will provide. Because Krishna can change the destiny. So he will provide. That's why he says for his devotees that I will maintain what devotee has, and I will, whatever they lack, I will provide. So this is the science. So that's why devotees, actually when there are devotees and there are sincere devotees, then their file is with Krishna. Then they in their life nothing happens as per the law of karma. Everything happens by the will of the Lord. In the life of devotees, in the life of sincere devotees, who are depending on the Lord, everything happens by the will of the Lord. And no karma can dare come and put you in distress. Even if you are destined to fall in distress, it cannot come to you. Even if you are going to meet with an accident, Krishna will see that it won't happen.
And if something is happening
in the life of devotees, then it should be taken thus as a will of the Lord. This is how devotee takes. Devotees, they always are in this mood that everything happening in my life is what Lord has a plan. Lord has a plan for us.
Also, he minimizes the karma that we get, the reaction that we get.
Yeah.
It is minimized.
Yeah, he minimizes or he can nullify also. It's up to him. He can minimize also, he can nullify completely. Because he can burn by chanting of the holy name or by hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, he can burn all this prarabdha karma like this if the devotee wants, by taking shelter of the Lord. Yes, we have to cross that test. But once we cross this, we will become matured in Krishna consciousness. We will be very advanced. That's why one should have his own personal deities. So deity worship helps one to develop unalloyed faith in the Lord. It makes a huge difference in the life of devotees. When you have your personalities, so you are completely depending on them, on the mercy of the Lord. So you always remember your duties and in your work, in your office, everywhere. So it is very important that we should get attached to one deity, serve them nicely. Like we take care of your children, we take care of your wife and your family, take care of your friends. Similarly, we should take care of Krishna like that. So then that relationship will develop, that friendship will develop. Sakhyam atma nivedanam. So the sakhyam will come. How? When we are serving. Friendship will be there. Like when Bhishma Pitamaha, when he took a vow of, he said to Duryodhana that tomorrow either Krishna will lift the weapon or Pandavas won't be there. So when this news spread everywhere that Bhishma Pitama has taken a vow, so this reached Arjuna also, is Krishna also. So Krishna went to Arjuna and he said that, you're not afraid that Bhishma Pitama has taken a vow? That, yeah, I'm not afraid. But I'm you are there, so why should I be afraid of? You'll take care of, you're my sarthi, and Bhishma Pitama, if before Bhishma Pitama's arrows will come to me, it has to pass through you. So however Vishwamitra might be strong and powerful, I know you won't allow that to happen. It was true. So Krishna was thinking, what should I do now? So he sent Draupadi, go and touch feet of Vishnu Pitamaha. So he touched the feet of Vishnu Pitamaha. Vishnu Pitamaha said, Sobhagyavati Bhava. And then he saw, he was actually sleeping, and she touched while sleeping. And then Vishnu Pitamaha only saw that it was a lady. So he just said, Sobhagyavati Bhava. And then Krishna was standing outside. And then he woke up and saw it's Draupadi. And he said, where is this Krishna? He said, he's outside. He said, now how is this going to happen? Then Krishna sent all the Pandavas and said, now here you are taking about to kill us, and you are not even telling us how you should be defeated. So how is this going to work? And then Vishnu Pitamaha reveals to them that if you bring Shikhandi in front of me, then I'll keep my weapons, and then I'm all yours. Defeat me. So, like this, these examples are given to help us understand that how Krishna will help us also like this in a tricky situation. These examples are not just as a mythological. No, these are facts, and this Krishna is giving us a message to us in the form of Bhagavatam, that even though however tricky the situation is, but I will protect my devotees. That is for sure. Name bhakta pranashyati. Krishna will protect his devotees. This Krishna is saying. So this is Krishna consciousness. Any other questions? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Granthraj Srimad Bhagavatam ki. Srila Prabhupada Maharaj ki. So I have a humble request before I get up from this Vyasasana, that you are all very, very senior to me. By age, by all the means, and if by my words, by my actions, if I have committed any offenses at your lotus feet, I wish to beg forgiveness from all of you. If by my words have hurted you, or and please forgive me. I'm just trying my best to, I'm actually purifying myself by speaking these teachings of Prahlada Maharaj. Whatever good has come out from my mouth, I might try my best to stick with the teachings of Srila Prabhupada. What has good has come out from my mouth, please accept it. And what is bad was there, please leave it with me. And I sincerely request all of you to have this courses called as Bhagavat Charcha or Bhagavat Vidyalaya. So if you can start here, it's a ready-made structure. We are giving this everything free of cost, and we are providing syllabus and everything. If you can start, it will be wonderful. Thank you very, very much. Hare Krishna.
Great, Brajsunder.